What's up, this is GM, and before I start, I want to tell you about TubeBuddy. In case you don't know, TubeBuddy is a free website that will help you manage and grow your YouTube channel. Thanks to them, some of my videos even show up as top results. Want to give them a try? Check the description below for the link.
Today's product is TaoTronics 12-inch Selfie Ring Light. So as you can see right here, I already put the ring light on a tripod. And then at the bottom here, you can see all the things that come in the box. We've got a manual. We have a little bag for the tripod, which the tripod I already hooked up to the ring light. We also have two clamps for a cell phone or smartphone. And then on the right, we have a Bluetooth little transmitter, which I will go over in a bit. And you see there's a wire coming out of the ring light, which I will also be showing later on, but that's pretty much to control all the functions of the light itself. It is not detachable from the ring light itself, so keep that in mind. And the wire is a USB cable, so up here it's, let me go and pan back up. Up here, we just have it already connected to the ring light. You can't actually detach it from the ring light. However, the end of this wire is a USB, which you would most likely plug into a computer, a laptop. You could put it in a block and then plug it into a wall, a two-prong or three-prong block. I have tried that. I had no issues at all. So I'll go over some general info on this ring light, and then I'll go over how it works and my final thoughts on it. So it has 160 LED beads, three colors. It can go from white to warm yellow, and then it can go up to warm white. It has 10 brightness levels for each light mode, going by 10% increments. The tripod has a three-way pan head, which I will show. It's made of aluminum alloy. The tripod goes from 16.5 inches to 51 inches, which is 41 to 135 centimeters. The legs unfold to 30 inches wide. I will show it at full a little bit later on. The Bluetooth trigger works with most Android and iOS up to 33 feet or 10 meters. The smartphone holders work on phones from 1.9 inches to 3.2 inches wide, or 4.8 to 8.1 centimeters. The whole setup weighs about 2.2 pounds or 1 kilogram. Alright, so let's go ahead and take a look at the tripod first. So as you can see, each leg does have three clamps on it, so it can get very long. So right there is the max length of just one of the legs. We go ahead and clamp it down. So as you can see, it gets very tall. It gets about up to my shoulder width, which is more than enough for me personally, because when you're using these ring lights, most likely I would assume you'd be sitting down. And if you're not, that's not a big deal either, because as I'll show in a bit, you can also raise it a little bit higher. Let me go ahead and just take out all the legs first. Alright, so here we have it in full, so I'm going to go ahead and pan it up and down so you can get a good look of how tall this really is. It is a lot taller than I was expecting, and now I'm going to go ahead and raise it even higher. So right here, you just saw it goes really, really high. You can extend the center portion as well, and at this point it is now taller than even I am, and that is great. You get a very good full length ring light. So no matter what, this will be perfect for you when it comes down to height. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and lower this. If you see right here, let me go ahead and raise this up, you can actually collapse the tripod as well like this. Let me go ahead and move the wire out of the way. So you can collapse it and use it as a monopod as well if needed. However, I don't think that's going to be something that's very necessary for most people to use it as a monopod. Let me go ahead and close up the legs to make this a little smaller and go over the rest of the specs on this. I did want to go ahead and show the bottom real quick. It does have rubber pads, so that way it won't slip around. There isn't anything actually keeping this piece in place, so it can come off, because let me go ahead and just show you. If I was to pull this up, as you can see, it's no longer in this little area to kind of keep it stable, which isn't really a big deal since the ring light is very light, as I was mentioning before. You do want to keep in mind, though, that sometimes when you're putting it back down, it might not go right into place. So you want to make sure you get it right into the circular hole right there. And then another thing is you can't actually lock this in like most tripods. If you were to buy like an actual tripod, you could usually lock it in right here, so that way this doesn't keep bending back and forth. But that, again, isn't a very big deal considering how light this is. And it also doesn't have a hook. Again, not a big deal because this is super light. Usually what a hook down here would be for is to anchor down to put weight, so that way it doesn't sway around. But I don't think that'll be much of an issue either way. And I will explain why it really won't matter in a little bit. But first, let's go over the different knobs. Let me go and move this wire out of the way. So right here we have four knobs and then a lever right here. I'll go over each one. So this red one, you probably already saw me messing around with. It is to make this piece longer or shorter. You want to screw it in to lock it into place. Then we have this one, which pretty much lets the ring light go forward and backward. Then we have this knob right here in the back, where if you loosen it, it lets you turn the light left and right. I'm going to go and lock that one back in place. Then you have this knob right here. Let me go and loosen that one up, and that's to turn it left and right like this. So if you take into account all three, you realize that you can pretty much turn this ring light in a 360 however you need it. Then we have this knob down here, and I'm not going to loosen this one because what it's for is to lock this ring light in place. So you would loosen and tighten the ring light in place with this. And the screw that it uses is actually the same as pretty much any other tripod you'd buy. So if you wanted to, if you have your own tripod or if you wanted a better tripod, a sturdier tripod, you can just put this ring light onto its own tripod. So actually, you know what, I will go ahead and unscrew it so I can go ahead and show you what I am talking about. For most of you who probably have camera equipment, you've probably seen these before. So as you can see, the screw is exactly the same as you would find on a tripod of any other tripod. So you could just screw this ring light into any other tripod that you have at home. So that's another beauty of this. So let's say, for example, this tripod was to break after years of use. Well, then you can just take off the ring light and put it on your own tripod, and you don't need to buy a full new setup. Another thing I noticed was that there is a little loop here. I'm assuming this is for either securing it onto, let's say, your backpack or something like that. Maybe for carrying around too, you could put a very small thread through. I'm not really too sure what you would use it for. Most likely though, I would use it to hang my little Bluetooth shutter here, so that way I don't lose it as easily. All right, so now I wanted to go ahead and show you the two different phone mounts that it comes with. So the first one we have is a really nice flexible mount right here. As you can see, it does flex. It looks like it's a rigid pipe, but it actually does flex. And I'll go ahead and pull it, as you can see, to fit your phone. I'll show my phone in it in a bit. And then right here, you can loosen it. Let me go and get a good angle on that. You can loosen it so that way you can turn it on a ball hinge right there, and then tighten it to the place that you want it, so that way it doesn't rotate anymore. And then the way that you actually connect it onto here is, I'm gonna try to get as best of an angle as I can. So if you can see up here, there's a small screw, and that's where you would screw it in. So I'll go ahead and do that right now and show you what it looks like once it's in place. So obviously you wanna go ahead and make it straight and then just rotate it like so. And then bam, we have it in place. So I will go ahead and show you the next one right here. It is somewhat similar to this one in the fact that this mechanism is exactly the same for putting in the phone. We do have this little piece back here that you can loosen to turn on a ball and then tighten as you need it to. However, it's not actually flexible. As you can see right here, it doesn't bend at all. And then in the back, you'll see that it has this little contraption, and I'll go ahead and bring up a little closer, hopefully it'll be easy enough to see there. As you can see, it has a little contraption here. So what this does is you lock it into place and then you pull it down, and that'll just keep it there. So I'll go ahead and unlock it. And then what you want to do is there's a little rubber piece in here. You want to rotate it like this so that way you can open it and then just clamp it right onto the pole. So I went ahead and clamped it on. I'll go and raise it up a little bit higher. And since it has rubber inside, it's not going to slip up and down very easily. Then you want to put that metal piece. Let me see if I can get a better angle of that for you guys. So if you remember, there's a metal piece back here, and you want to go ahead, let me bring it a little bit closer. So you want to go ahead and bring this to the furthest notch you can, and then pull this, and bam, now it's really tight in place. I can't even rotate it back. So that's another thing you want to keep in mind is, so I'll go ahead and unlock it real quick. So there we go. I unlocked it, but accidentally made the metal piece run into the third ridge there. So run it over to exactly where you need it, and then lock it into the ridge that you can't, the farthest you can, so that way it has a nice tight fit. And it might take some effort to get it on. Like for me right there, it just took a little bit of effort to actually get it tight, but bam, we got it. So as you can see, this allows for two different setups for your phone. You can keep it under the ring light, you can keep it in the middle of the ring light. Let me go ahead and, raise that up real quick. So yeah, you can keep it either in the middle of the ring light, you can keep it down here. Once you put your phone in, you could also rotate it like this or like this. So I'll go ahead and put my phone in. Let me go ahead and grab my phone real quick. All right, so I got one of my older phones because it's a little bit bigger actually. It's a pretty big phone that I have. And you can put this then right in here. So I'll go ahead and pull this out. It does have rubber on the inside to keep it in place. You could also put it in backwards if, depending on how you're planning on recording this, but most likely you're gonna wanna keep it forward like this. Same with up here, you can just put it in like that and bang, it's perfect. You can rotate it then like this and keep it straight, however you need it to be, and it will be perfectly locked into place. Then of course, I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the light as well so I can show you how it looks with the light on. Again, you want to make sure that you plug it in. So let me show you what the plug looks like. So right here, we have a USB. So I'm gonna be plugging it into a laptop. I'll go ahead and do that right now. You know that it's on because there will be a slight blue glow down here. Might be a little hard to see. And this is pretty much how you control this entire ring light. So we have a power button. We have the buttons, the plus and minus for increasing it by 10% increment or decreasing by 10% increment for the power. Then the center one, it's a little cycle button for the three different color modes. So I'll go ahead and turn it on. All right, so as you can see right now, my room is pretty dark. I did try to turn off most of the lighting or close all the lighting I could, but as you can see, there is some coming in over on the left side. But what I've done is I put the ISO down to about 200, and at 200, pretty much what you're noticing is it looks really dark. But for those of you who aren't familiar with ISO, by putting it lower, you're gonna have a lot less grain showing up in your footage. And if you're getting this ring light specifically for vlogs or YouTube videos, you're gonna wanna keep your ISO pretty low. And to fix the darkness, you're gonna need some lights. So let's go ahead and see how this ring light will do at 200 ISO. Okay, so right here, we have it at max brightness on a cool white. As you can see, it is brightening up the whole scene very well. And I will go ahead and switch to the other two. So the next one is a warmer light, and then the next one is the very cool white light. And as you can see, all three light it up perfectly. It's exactly how bright I need it. And honestly, I don't actually shoot at this low of an ISO as is. The reason I have it so low is just so you can get an idea of how well this really works, that you can even keep the ISO this low. I'm gonna go ahead and change it by the 10% increment so you can see the range in the brightness. So right now we have it at max. So down by 10, down by 20, down by 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and then 100. So as you can see, even at a pretty low brightness, it's still really helpful because you can get exactly how much light you need. So you have a lot of control on how bright this light really gets. So I'm gonna go ahead and raise it back up to max. So you can see it really does work very well overall for everything that you need brightness wise. And I'll go ahead and pan this over towards the light a bit so that way you can get an idea of what the color light looks like around the edges. So as you can see, it is very, very bright coming off of it. It does have 160 beads inside putting out that light. And then I'll go ahead and lower it a couple times. All right, so let's take a look at this little device right here that we have. Up in the top right, or in the top left, my bad, we have the LED indicator light. On the side, we have an on-off switch. The top one is going to be your camera button for iOS. The bottom one is your camera button for Android. In the back is where you would put in the battery, and it did come with the battery, so I'll go ahead and turn it on, and there you can see the indicator light. And then you could take the picture or start a video by just pressing that button, so you don't have to fiddle with your device, especially if you don't have your device right in front of you. So that's a nice little additional feature that they included with it as well. All right, so now on the left, you see TaoTronics ring light, And then on the right, you see my other ring light that I've been using for the past few years. And I want to just give a quick comparison of these two and why I actually prefer TaoTronics. So, first off, price-wise, TaoTronics is definitely a lot cheaper than the one I have on the right. So the one on the left, the TaoTronic one, I believe I got for around $40 or $50. The one on the right, I don't remember the brand name, but I remember getting it for around $100 and something dollars. I think it was around $130, $140. And yeah, that's a pretty big price difference. So you would expect the right one to have a lot better features. So the biggest difference between the left and the right would probably be that the left one, the ring light is made of different material and it is a little bit smaller. It is 12 inches. The right one is a 16-inch ring light. And personally, I don't actually need a 16-inch ring light. The reason I bought the 16-inch at the time was because it was pretty much, I was thinking, oh, I need that much light, but I really don't. As I showed you earlier, a 12-inch ring light does enough. In fact, for the 16-inch ring light, I actually keep it at the lowest setting because if I have a light any higher, it's always too overwhelming. So that's one thing. You don't really need to break the bank on a ring light, especially considering the ring light is going to be pretty close to you anyways. Then another thing about the TaoTronics versus my other one on the right is that the tripod on the left, you can put any tripod for this ring light versus the one on the right, it comes with a tripod that you can't actually replace. If you wanted to get a new tripod for the one on the right, you have to buy that tripod. And so if you were to break it, and I actually have already broken part of it, so the issue I now have is that I'm stuck with how it is. So my current issue is that the right tripod originally could get pretty high up. It actually could get, I think, a few feet higher than TaoTronics, but when it did get that high, it wasn't very stable because, as you can see, the tripod legs on it aren't as great as a real tripod. And then when it got that high, I don't need it that high. What's the point of having a ring light a few feet over your head, honestly? For most people, that isn't going to be necessary. So yeah, I think that TaoTronic, the fact that they made it to where you can switch it out with pretty much any type of tripod is a very big plus. So now for another really big difference that I noticed was the phone holders. As you can see on TaoTronic, we have two phone holders, and on the other one, we have one, and the one on this one, you can put onto three different slots. So it has a middle, a left, and a right. Currently, I have it on the leftmost side as we're facing it, and yeah, that's great and all, but it's not very adjustable, and you really are limited on what you can do. You can only keep your phone also in a landscape mode versus the TaoTronics. You can adjust exactly how you need, and you have two different ways of putting the phone on, so you don't need to technically have the phone right in the center of your ring light, unlike the one I have on my right. As for the lighting modes, they both have the exact same lighting modes. They both have the same color modes. The only difference is probably a little bit more control in the lighting for the right one. But like I said, I have to keep it at the lowest setting because it's too bright. And almost no one really needs a ring light as bright as what I have on the right. As you saw, with a setting very low for my camera, the ISO very low and the lighting at max, it was way bright enough to handle everything I need. And I bought the TaoTronic one specifically to replace my right one because, as I mentioned, the right one is now no longer adjustable because the tripod's broken and it's just not the most sturdy either. So at this point, I'm actually planning on switching completely to the TaoTronic one and just probably using this right one as just, I don't even know, just a side light, I suppose. Not really anything I need it for anymore. All right, so it's time for me to just kind of sum up my final thoughts on this product. So the best thing about TaoTronic is that you can put the ring light on any tripod. As I've pretty much mentioned multiple times today, that you can just put it on any tripod. If you find that the tripod it came with is too unsturdy or too thin or too light, use your own tripod. Tripods are pretty cheap as is as well, and you don't have to worry about having to replace tripods then, like I mentioned I have issues with on the right one. Another big benefit is that the tripod and the ring light are super light, which is great if you need to take it with you. The light modes are pretty bright. They are exactly what I need. I actually don't even need to put this one at max since, like I said, I keep my footage at around ISO 400 when I shoot. So This left one, the TaoTronic, is perfect. It also feels really sturdy. Compared to my other ring light, I'm not as worried about the TaoTronic one breaking if I dropped it in my room. The right one, I'm always worried about dropping and breaking it, because as I mentioned, even the tripod itself already broke so easily when I barely even used it. And I think another big pro is that the tripod comes with a bag, so that way it is easy to carry with you. However, I do have some cons, and pretty much my only real big con is that it would have been nice if they gave a bag for the ring light itself, but the ring light itself doesn't have a bag, and that makes me a little worried if I was to carry it around with me. So my solution for this, for you, especially if you don't have maybe a very sturdy bag at home, is to maybe keep the box and keep it in the box, because the box is well made. It does have a lot of support for the ring light, so it won't get damaged. But if you do have your own bag, one of those types of bags you use if you go to like a store for grocery shopping or something, not a grocery bag, but if you know what I'm talking about, one of those tweed bags, I believe, you can put it into that and that will be do just fine. And as I mentioned, since it is so sturdy, I'm not as worried about it breaking. And just as a comparison, my other ring light did come with a bag. However, the bag is super thin, and honestly, it doesn't protect this ring light at all. It's just to prevent it from scratches. I'm always worried about this one breaking, and considering how much more it costs, I think it was around $80 to $100 more than the TaoTronic one. Considering it costs that much more, you would expect it to have a lot better, pretty much, structure and safety, but I guess not really. And despite this small hiccup of not having a bag for the ring light, I would say that they made this ring light perfect by giving you two adjustable phone holders, which gives you the exact setup you need. As I've already mentioned, it's way better than the one that they gave for my other ring light. And yeah, I just think TaoTronic did a great job on this. That's it for this video. Link to the product is in the description below. If you found the video helpful, I'd love it if you could leave a thumbs up and subscribe. If you have any questions, leave a comment below as well. Thank you for watching.